Hello beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. I'm Ifama. So today we're going to be making this beautiful top. The only thing I changed is the sleeve of mine. So if this looks like what you're interested in, make sure you watch till the end. And if you're yet to subscribe, please hit the subscribe button. Let's dive into the video. To begin, these are all the measurements you are going to be needing for this. You are going to be needing your bust circumference, your waist circumference, which is the length, the place the top is going to end as well. The length of the top, which is 19 inches, your shoulder to the length, your shoulder to the desired length, and then the shoulder, which is 15 inches. Okay, you also need your sleeve measurement and your round sleeve, right? So to make this, you need at least 1.5 yards of fabric if you are small, or 2 yards if you want to have the exact same sleeve that this style have, right? So this, you already know that sleeve consumes lots of material. So if you want the exact same sleeve on the thumbnail, then you get at least 2 yards if you are on the smaller size. Okay, so this style, the back has a smoking, the back has a smoked band, which is going to aid the style, the top, to be easily worn. Okay, because you already know that the top do not have a zipper, so that smoky is going to help it to pass easily when we are putting it on, right? So having said this, let's dive into the video. So to begin, I have this pattern I already drafted out. This is for the back. As you can see, this is the back neckline. Okay, we are going to be using this pattern to cut out the back. There's nothing unusual going on in this pattern. This is just our bust line, as we already know, and our chest line. Okay, this is the dart. Now this dart is just going to be for the front. The back is not going to be having any dart. That is because the back has a band with that has a smoky. Okay, the band of the back was smoked, so the back do not need a gather. And for the back is going to end somewhere like this, somewhere like 1 inch or 2 inches below the bust line, depending on how wide you want your own smoky band to be. And then the rest that is going to make up for the length of the front is going to be smoked, okay, which means you are going to be cutting it extra, right? So this is just the back. I'm going to be using this back to cut out the front, right? So when you've done drafting out a basic bodice like this, that happens to be your back, right, all you just have to do is come down with 1 or 2 inches below your bust line, cut this out, then use this to cut a longer fabric for the band. Okay, so but for me, I'm going to go straight to working on the front. Now this is our front. This is the pattern we are going to be using for the front. This is the back, as you already know. Now this is the bust line and this is the chest line. So what I'm going to do now is to first of all go ahead and extend this chest line to touch the other side. Right? So this is what we have, right? This is the center. This is our center front. This is the bust and the chest line. And this is my dart. Now, this dart, I use 0.75 instead of 0.5 inches. So you can as well use whatever works for you. Okay? So the first thing we are going to do now is start working on the Queen Anne neckline. Alright? So what I'm going to do, of course, we want our shoulder to be equal. The shoulder at the front, of the front and the back, we are going to have it equal. So what I'm going to do now is to divide my armhole. Now the armhole I used here is 7.5. I'm going to divide it by 2, and that is going to give us what we have here. Okay, this is the half of our armhole measurement. So what I'm going to go ahead to do now is to connect this half of our armhole measurement with a broken line. We are going to bring it outside like this. It's a broken line. Then we are going to connect from this tip of the shoulder with a slanted line to meet this broken line here. Okay, this is just for the Queen Anne neckline that we have in this style. All right, so now when we've gotten this, if you look closely in the style, you're going to see that it has something like a slant here. It went down this way here. So I'm just going to use my ruler to connect like so. Okay, now this is what we have. This part is going to be our shoulder. Let me label this the shoulder because we are going to be cutting it off. okay? This is the shoulder. We are going to be cutting it off, right? So when we've gotten this, this depends on how deep you want your bust to be. So if you want the bust, the person you're making this for, if you want this person's bust to show, or you want yours to really show, you can still come down from half of the armhole measurement. But we don't want our bust to be showing in this particular project. That's why we are using the half of the armhole measurement. So when we've gotten this, all we have to do now is to connect. We are going to connect this point to the midpoint here, okay? You can still go down if you want your bust to be showing in the center. You can still go down, but I'm going to be stopping mine on the chest line. So I started to go down a little bit more so that the bust will be showing a little bit, okay? So when we've gotten that, what I'm just going to do is to connect to the end of the paper here, which is on to the other side. Okay, so this is what we have, right? This is how the neck is going to come for this side and for this side as well. So when we have gotten this, I'm just going to go ahead and use my marker to trace this out so that it becomes more visible. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and cut all this out. So when we're done cutting out, we are going to place the shoulder aside. And then we are going to start working on this. All right. So the first thing I'm going to do is to divide what we have here into two. I'm going to divide what you have here into two. Okay. And then I'm going to connect from the midpoint to the tip of our dart. Okay, so when we've gotten this, the next thing we want to do now is to open this up. Okay, we want to close our underbust dart and transfer that dart to this part. All right, so I'm going to open this up. And then open this up as well. Now, when we've done this, we're just going to close up this dart. It's just like transferring our underbust dart to this part, okay? Because this part, we are going to have a gather here. We are going to have excess here that we are going to use to gather it and give us that effect that we have in the style we're trying to recreate. Okay, so when we've gotten this, this is all for the cutting. What we're just going to do is we're going to trace exactly what we have here on our pattern. Okay, remember for the back, our back is going to have a band that we are going to smoke. Okay, so that band, you should add extra allowance to it so that when we smoke it, it's still going to be enough for the back. The back do not have any zipper. That smoky is going to make it easy to wear. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and trace this out on our actual fabric. So here I went ahead to arrange my pattern on my fabric. Now what you're going to do is to make sure you add your sewing allowance on both sides, okay? Because you already know that this side is also entering the shaping side. So I'm going to be adding 1 inch on both sides. I will not be adding anything on the armhole. And then I'm going to be adding 0.5 inches on top here, because you know we are still going to join our shoulder, right? So for the center here, we are going to be adding 0.5 inch as well for the turning or folding, depends on what you are going to be doing with yours. So if you want to use a lining, also add your allowance. Now for the down, I'm going to be folding my down, so I'm going to be adding 1 inch for the down here, okay? and our fabric is unfold, because you know this is the front, it has two sides, okay? So our fabric here is unfold. I'm going to go ahead now and cut out. So for the shoulder as well, I'm also going to add 0.5 inches for the down, where we are going to be joining to our fabric. Then for the neckline, 0.5 inches for the turning of the neck, the shoulder 0.5 inches for the joining, and then the armhole. If you have been following my channel, you are going to notice I don't like adding any allowance to the armhole. Okay, so when I've gotten this, I'm going to also go ahead and cut out. So these are all our fabric. We are done cutting. This is the front, the two sides of the front, right? These are the two sides of the front. Now we are going to be gathering this part and this part as well, okay? So this is the shoulder. If you are working with a lighter fabric, I advise you should cut this into four pieces, so that you are going to use one to turn one. But I'm working with a thick fabric, so I'm not going to be using one to turn one. Instead, I'm just going to be folding it in with my bias, or just folding it in normally. Now for the back, remember when I said for the back you can add some extra allowance to the one you are going to be using for the smoky band, right? So for me, I added 10 inches to this. So after smoking, you know, smoking, we normally bring it together. After smoking, we are still going to have something that will be enough for the back, okay? So when we are cutting it out, also endeavor to add your allowance for the up and the down as well. All right, so now we are through with the cutting process. We are going to go ahead and start sewing. All right, so to begin, the first part I'm going to be sewing is the front. I'm just going to pipe this mid of this front. I'm going to pipe the front neck and also the back neck, okay? When I'm done with piping the front and the back neck, I'm going to go ahead and pipe our shoulder as well. So here I'm done with piping. This is what it looks like after we are done piping, and this is the shoulder, right? So the next thing I'm going to do is to gather here. Now whatever you're doing, make sure that after gathering here, whatever you have is going to be equal with what we have here, right? So remember that what you are making is going to have a gather here and still be equal with the down part of the shoulder, okay? So I'm just going to sew a loose stitch, then gather it and attach it to this shoulder, right? Just going to make a loose stitch, gather and attach. We're going to do the exact same thing for this side as well. So this is what we have after we are done with the front, right? This is how beautiful the front already looks, okay? So we are going to place this aside, and the next thing we are going to work on is the band for the back, okay? So this is the smoking thread I'm going to use, and please don't be like me, get the color of the material you are using. I'm sure they have red colored smoking thread, I'm sure they have white as well. I don't know how many colors they have in smoking thread, but I'm sure they have multiple colors in this thread. So but because this is the one I can find at home today, so I'm going to be using this black one, okay? So go ahead and reel this on your bobbin, okay? This is the bobbin that my machine is using. This is the reeler that my machine is using. Go on and reel it just the way you reel your normal thread on a normal day. Go ahead and reel it. Then you're going to use your regular thread at the top, and this one will be at the bottom, okay? You only need this for the reeler. On your normal thread, you're going to still be on the top, you're going to still be using your normal thread, okay? So go ahead and reel it. Then after reeling it and fixing your machine, you go ahead and be matching it line by line. You can be using 0.5 inches between each line, you can be using between each line, you can be using 0.25, okay? So just go ahead and make it very neat and very straight, match it till you get to the down, okay? But before you start matching, go ahead and fold your fabric so that it's going to be neat and it's not going to be so hard for you to fold after you're done smoking, okay? So having said that, I'm going to quickly go ahead and smoke this, then show us what it looks like. So this is what we have after we are done. So because of the kind of fabric I'm using, obviously you can already see that the rubber thread do not do its most excellent job, but at least you have an idea of what we're talking about now, right? And I also forgot to add that if you are smoking, make sure that the rubber thread is at the wrong part, which means you are going to be sewing from the front of your fabric. So having said that, this did not gather enough, but we are still going to use it like that, right? I hope you understand what we are trying to explain with this. So what I'm going to do now is to go ahead and join, right? I'm just going to go ahead and join this to be like this. Then I'm going to quickly go ahead and join our shoulder and the sleeve of your choice, if you want it to be that exact same sleeve, or maybe you do not know how to make that sleeve. If you can tell us in the comment section, so we are going to make a separate video explaining how that sleeve is being achieved. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and finish this. I'm going to join this. I'm going to shape and add the sleeve, then I'll show us the final look. So this is what we achieved after we're done. This is what the top looks like. So if you're yet to subscribe, please do hit the subscribe button, and please give this video a thumbs up, endeavor to share with your friends, and yeah, they can also drop a comment. So I'll see you guys again in the next one. Bye.